Hello everybody, this is Dr. Mahesh P. Chougule, Assistant Professor, Department of Social Work, Walchand College of Arts and Science, Solapur. Today in this video, we are going to learn principles of social action. Learning outcomes. The students will be able to learn principles of social action. The students will be able to apply the principles in their fieldwork practice. Principles of social action. Considering the Gandhian direct mobilization model of social action, Bruto in 1984 gave six principles of social action. The six principles of social action given by Bruto are as follows. Number one, credibility building. It is a task of creating public image of leadership. Leader, organizations, followers become the warriors of truth, justice and rights. It gave due recognition from the opponent. It can be built by gestures and example setting. Now let us see how it can be built. Gestures of goodwill. For example, Gandhiji gestures of goodwill towards British as a non-violence projected credibility of Gandhi as a true leader of humanitarian philosophy. Example number two. That is example setting. For example, Dr. Rajendra Singh, the Magsaysay Award winner of 2001, had set up example of water conservation in many villages of Rajasthan by making check dams through mobilization of village resources. So these are the examples of credibility building principle. Coming to the principle of legitimization. Legitimization is a process of convincing target group and the general public that the movement objectives are morally right. It justifies the movement action. Justification adds to fresh argument to put forth social action. There are three approaches to legitimization. The three approaches to legitimization are number one, theological and religious approach to legitimization. For example, Gandhi used this approach during freedom movement. He appealed to serve Dharma by revolting against injustice of British. Number two, that is moral approach to legitimization. For example, people associated in the campaign against child labor through peaceful rallies, persuasive speeches, use of media, organizing drawing competition among school children have helped to create an environment against child abuse in the country. As a result of this, employing children in any occupation is considered morally wrong. Number three, legal technical approach to legitimization. People engaged with the campaign for people's right to health have based their argument on the human rights issue. Fundamental rights and government's commitment to health for all, it gives legitimized right to the movement. Principle number three, that is principle of dramatization. Dramatization is a principle of mass mobilization. Leader galvanize people, the population, into action by emotional appeal, by heroism, sensational news, novel procedures, and slogans. For example, the song of Martin Luther King that we shall overcome, we shall overcome someday, or deep in my heart I do believe we shall overcome someday, has created a very crucial effect among the followers of the movement. Coming to the principle of multiple strategies, there are two basic approaches to the development: conflictual and non-conflictual approaches. Taking the main thrust of the program, one can classify it as political, economical, or social. Multiple strategies uses combined approaches. Zeltman and Duncan have identified four development strategies from their experience of community development. The four development strategies of Zeltman and Duncan are: number one, educational strategies. In this strategy, the prospective participants are educated at the individual, group, and mass level. This is one of the basic requisites or requirements of social action. People or target groups are given necessary information about the issue. By creating awareness, people are motivated and persuaded to participate in the movement. Number 2. Persuasive strategy. Persuasive strategy is the adoption of set of actions or procedures to bring about changes by reasoning, arguing, and inducing others to accept the particular viewpoint. Facilitative strategy. This refers to set of procedures and activities to facilitate the participant of all sections of society in the mass movement. Number 4. Power strategy. It involves the use of compulsion to obtain the desired objectives. The forms of coercion may vary. Gandhiji used social boycott as one of the techniques of power strategy. Coming to the fifth principle of social action given by Brito, that is principle of dual approach. Any activist has to build counter system or revive some unused system which thought to be beneficial to mobilization of the public on self-help basis without involving the opponent. Now the sixth principle, that is principle of manifold program. Developing a variety of program with objective to mobilize masses, and this can be done or classified into three parts, that is social, economical and political sector. These are the references used for this video and for further study. Thank you very much.